Well, I really hope I fix the focus this time. So hello, Emmet Ryan from Ball in Europe here, and if this isn't the first time you've been looking at one of our videos, we hope I finally got the focus down right in this camera, but maybe I haven't. But we're here to talk today, not about the quality of my camera, but about Victor Wembanyama, the most talked about European prospect ever, which is saying quite a lot considering another European prospect who we will mention in this video, don't you worry, or at least past European prospect. And we've got a lot to talk about Victor. We're going to look at three different areas, really. One is the choices he had available to him, and what the choice he made, essentially. Two, what the trade-off with that was. And finally, we're going to look at what that means for his last month and a bit of action with his current team, Metropolitan, in 92. Emmet here, and guess what I forgot to do again? That was to tell you early in the video to subscribe. We need to get up to 1,000 so we can finally get monetized by YouTube, so we can literally make more content for you from around Europe, not just from my wonderful setup here with all my caps. Alrighty, catch you soon. So first of all, Wembanyama made a big, brave choice, legitimately brave choice, at the end of last season. He was with ASVEL Villeurbanne, who are royalty in French basketball, really. They have done it all, pretty much. The only thing they haven't really done is win EuroLeague, but they are playing in EuroLeague, which is a big thing. And Tony Parker's their guy. I mean, it's about as good a choice you can make, in theory, if you're a young French player developing. The obvious issue for Wembanyama was he wanted minutes, guaranteed minutes, and lots of them. So he made a big, big choice. And he went to Metropolitan 92, who are have a very long Bourgogne Levallois. My French is terrible. My apologies to my girlfriend, who has amazing French. And although she's amazing, like 16 languages. So, you know, I'm doing pretty good here with two, English and Irish. And middling German is far too kind of my German. I would say bad, but better than most of you German. And so, yeah, he's with Metropolitan, who are coached by Vincent Sancollet, who is also, of course, the French national team coach. And he has played for Metropolitan much heavier minutes, effectively doubled his minutes this year. He's on 32 minutes when he was on about 18, so just shy of doubling his minutes. But remember, it's 32 out of 40 for the NBA fans tuning in, not out of 48. So those are really heavy minutes by 40-minute game standards. Also, we've seen that increase in his production. Like, his points are up way higher. Like, he's in the 20s in his points in his average for Metropolitan. His rebounds, again, doubled. He's about 9.9 per game. Well, he is 9.9 per game. He's just shy of the double-double. Like, his blocks are up, steals, assists, all of that. He's showing he can create, he can show he can do everything. And he's, largely speaking, improving, you know, at the core levels. Like, his free throw percentage slightly up at 83. He's shooting about 54.5. From two, and from three, he's still at the 30% range, but, like, you know, like we've seen before with young Euros and that they tend to actually improve their three if they already start being guys who are confident at three young. Like, generally speaking, when they go over, that actually improves. So I'm not worried about his three-point percentage. But what he did, above all that, was got games. He already, this season, has played as many games as he did last season with ASVEL, which is particularly notable because ASVEL were playing EuroLeague, which is a very, very heavy slate. So Wembanyama has gotten what he wants. He's obviously effectively doubled his minutes. He's played way more minutes than he did last year. He's got regular, consistent competition, like guaranteed game a week, plus a couple of cup games. Actually, I forgot the cup games. He has played more games this season than he did the whole of last season. Although, actually, the cup games last year. Forget that. He's played more, as many league games as he did last year, and he's going to very soon play more games than he did the whole of last year. And so, you know, all very positive. Obviously, there was an injury shortening to last season, but still, all really, really positive. Like, a lot of us were hoping to see him at Eurobasket last year, but the real reason we were hoping for that was we were afraid we weren't going to see him at all. Fortunately, the LNB changed that very quickly. France's league used to be one of the hardest to watch if you weren't in the country it's being shown. Essentially, there just wasn't really an international streaming option that was easy to get in a lot of countries, mine included, Ireland. And so I was like, oh, well, going to be tough to watch Wembanyama this season. We're going to get to the why of that in a second. And then, of course, after those 2 days of fear, the LNB said, hey, we're making the LNB free for everybody to watch. And then, oh, and by the way, we're also going to put it on the NBA with a league pass, and it'll be part of that. So it suddenly went to being, oh, right, he's actually one of the easiest players, arguably the easiest prospect in history to watch. Because, like, you know, with other prospects, we saw a lot of their games, we could see a lot of their games, I don't think it was quite as direct access to 100% of their games worldwide as this for anyone, to be completely honest. So we've gotten to see a whole lot of Wembanyama. So on that score, he has made a brilliant choice. Now, here's where we get to the tricky bit. Yeah, a lot of French teams played in Europe this year. Metropolitan is not one of them. Monaco, at the time of recording, are in the early playoffs. Cholet are in the FIBA Euro Cup final. They've got the second leg coming up. I think it's actually the night this goes out. So that's, you know, the fourth competition in Europe, but still, it's a key point to the depth, because you also have Paris and Strasbourg make quarterfinals in their respective competitions, the Euro Cup and BCL, respectively, Basketball Champions League. So we've seen French teams make progress in Europe. It's a good, deep league. You notice I didn't mention Asvel there. They were in EuroLeague. Well, they will be probably next year as well with the way the licenses work. But they were not good in EuroLeague this year. They were very bad at basketball. But the key thing with that is it meant it limited the vision of competition we saw with Wembanyama. And it's interesting because now we're going to mention the one I was talking about. Luka Doncic somehow was less talked about than Wembanyama, which to me is kind of wild to say out loud, because I talked a lot about Luka Doncic in 2-3 years leading up to him being drafted. And there was a lot of people unsure because of the level he had played against being one of them. Luka Doncic's level, in case you're trying to remember, was the second best basketball league in the world, EuroLeague, the first being the NBA, and the second best national league in the world, the ACB of Spain, best being the NBA, although the NBA does cross a border. Hi, Canada. Love you. Great place to go. So he played basically the highest level you could play without playing in the NBA. Like, this is way bigger than the G League, G League Ignite, and obviously way bigger than college. But back then, which is only a few years ago, these weren't guarantees somehow in the eyes of average people, even though the obvious thing of the rule set, and more importantly, the 24-second shot clock, and therefore the speed that came with that, meant, frankly, playing in Europe was a far better development suit than college. And so, yeah, Luka was my last talk about the Wembanyama. But let's talk about those competitions Luka played in. The ACB in Spain, again, supremely deep. France isn't as deep, but at least it has shown it has way more depth than some other leagues he might have ended up in Europe either. The big thing is Metropolitan opted against entering any European competition this year. They could never have got into EuroLeague based on the criteria, but EuroCup would probably have been an option. Based on their position, I think the BCL would have been an option, and pretty much if you can breathe, the FIBA Euro Cup is a guaranteed option. But there was always an option there for Metropolitan, and they didn't take it. Simple as that. And that suited Wembanyama. He liked the structure and order of knowing what he was going to be doing week in, week out. The only other games he played were the France national team games. So again, gave him a big audience when it mattered. But very, very different. Very structured and very controlled. Now, it showed, obviously, great self-confidence of Wembanyama because he is, like, being talked about like nobody else. Apparently the rights to get the French League, by the way, in the US for the NBA or whoever technically paid for it with the NBA pass, I'm not sure if it's Turner or the NBA, was only 133,000 euros, which bargain for the whole season for all of Wembanyama's games. Damn. Like, you know, if I'd known it was that cheap, I'd have tried being intermediary. I wouldn't have succeeded, but listen, you know, give a guy a chance. And so, yeah, huge, huge question there in terms of level competition, because yes, the French league is deep, but we've only seen him play against French league sides. And, you know, Monaco is a big challenge, which he's hopefully going to get a really big challenge against, which I'll mention. Yeah, you know, there's still that issue of we haven't seen him against the best of the best. Because the bottom line is Spain is deeper, and the top teams of EuroLeague that he might have ended up playing against had he stayed at Asvel, your Olympiacos is, your Barcelona's, of course, also in Spain, Real Madrid, Monaco in his own league, fine. Zalgiris, Partizan, all playoff teams, all very different environments, very different atmospheres. He didn't get that. And even if he played against other teams from other leagues, at least we'd have seen a different flavor to the test he was getting. So that kind of irked me. I'd like to see him play, even in the FIBA Euro Cup, which is obviously, in terms of depth, lower than just a French league on its own. But I'd like to see them just see that variety of styles of tests he could have faced, and we didn't get to really watch that this year. So that is a concern. Not a major one, because we kind of get lucky in terms of what's next. Yeah, I do love my little gestures and finger stuff and whatever. But what's next is, in about a month's time, less than that, on the 23rd of May, the French playoffs start. As things currently stand, Wembanyama and his crew are going to get the second seed. It'll probably be a surprise if they don't. they have about 5 games left, and it's looking good for them to get second. They will probably get a team they've already dealt with fairly handy before, in the 7 seed, 8 seed. It's still very jumbled about, so I'm not going to go on who the 7, 8 seed is right now, because there's like three, four teams might end up at that 7 seed. They're not going to get the 1 seed, which means they get the 8 seed in the playoffs. That's a best of 3 series, which is obviously very limited, but at least it's something, and it brings a bit of playoff basketball to things. One of the potentials is Paris Basket, but that's a story in its own, and I will wait to do that if it happens. But the key thing is, if they get through that series, which I think they will be good enough to, and that Wembanyama will have to be a big part of, is then they go into the next series, which would be best of 5, and so are the finals. But the semifinal series presents, as the standings are right now, 2 really different options. You got JDA Dijon, who had a strong, albeit unsuccessful, BCL campaign, but showed real veteran nous. Like, they're built around a bunch of players who know what they are and what they can do, but have physicality and finesse on the interior, which is obviously going to be a big thing with Wembanyama. They're the 3rd seed right now. The 6th seed right now is Asvel, which is just drama made to happen. So if Asvel could overcome Dijon, it would be the obvious drama. If Dijon overcome Asvel, and obviously we assume Mets get through to the semis, we get a best of 5 series with Wembanyama that's really, 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 really meaty. And then we get to the last bit, because if they get to the final, I would be extremely shocked if it's not Monaco in the final. Like, this championship is Monaco's to lose. That's best of 5 again. And yeah, you know, it's Monaco. Like, they're one of the best teams in Europe. They might very well be in the EuroLeague Final 4 this year. I might well be hiccuping and yawning at the same time. But like, that's a serious test. And he gets to do that right in line with the NBA draft. Because here's one thing to bear in mind. Wembanyama will not be over for draft prep unless his playoff campaign is a disaster. Unless they either go out in the first round or get swept really in the second. If they make it out, don't make it out of the second, he will be in New York. I don't even know it's New York. He will be there for draft night. I've forgotten. I don't know where the NBA draft is this year. He'll be over. He'll get to, you know, hear his name called in person. But the finals in France could go as long as the 24th of June. That, for those of you who don't know, is 2 days after the NBA draft, which is on the 22nd of June. France has always been, and for many years now, really, I say always, but really is always, one of the latest finishing leagues in Europe, and this year is no exception. So we've seen it before with Frank Nicolina, who missed out on being there on draft night because he was playing the championship game in France at the same time. Actually, did he fly straight over? You know, he went over, didn't he, and back. I forgot what happened with Frank. Let me know in the comments what happened with Frank, but I know it was weird there was a crossover between that game and the draft. Tell me in the comments what happened with Frank there. Do that. But we've seen the issue before come up, where there's crossover. Like, and Wembanyama is, if he's in the middle of a series and they have a chance of winning, and realistically, come the 22nd, it'll be a case of it's all or nothing stage, games-wise, it's championship deciding games. Yeah, he's not going to fly over for the draft. So the very first pick, overall pick, may not get his name called. Listen, I think he's going to do great in the NBA. I think he's already proven he's great here in Europe. But it's his last, you would think, playoff series he'll ever play in Europe. And that, for me, makes this a fascinating playoffs to watch. If you haven't already, please subscribe. We're trying to get all the way up to 1,000. It'd be great to have all the support you can get. And yeah, listen, thanks. Leave your comments below. And, you know, let me know what you want me to talk about my next video as well. And how wrong I was or how right I was with Frank. Alrighty, slán liv.